The final topic for this module is scattering parameters, or S parameters. If you go into RF engineering, or if you're already in RF engineering, you'll be using S parameters all the time. S parameters are the system parameters that are most readily measurable. They allow us to characterize a network from the outside without necessarily knowing what's going on internally. To do this, we put test signals at the various ports of the system and measure where that energy comes out. S parameters are an example of a port analysis method, meaning that we're characterizing a system based purely on its behavior at the locations where energy flows into or out of the system. These locations are known as ports, and an in-port network is a network that has N ports. Let's look, for example, at this two-port system. This system has two ports, port 1 on the left and port 2 on the right. Each port has its own characteristic impedance. Port 1 has characteristic impedance Z01, and port 2 has characteristic impedance Z02. This network may be driven at either port, and each driving signal has a possibility of reflection, which results in a signal traveling back out the input port, or transmission, which results in a signal passing through to the opposite port. This diagram shows the complete set of signal path possibilities, including input at either port. Note also that I've added an extra subscript to the output voltages. Here, the first subscript indicates the port at which the energy exits the system, and the second subscript indicates the port at which the energy entered the system. So for example, V21 is a voltage signal that entered the system at port 1 and exited at port 2. So the total signal coming port 1 is V12, the portion that was put in at 2, was transmitted, and came out 1, plus V11, the portion that was put in 1, reflected, and came back out port 1. In order to figure out how much of the output signal to attribute to each of these sources, we have to make a series of measurements, each of which involves only a single input signal. This is the first measurement we need to characterize a two-port system. Note that we're only driving the first port. Also note that we must match terminate the second port. This is because if the second port is not match terminated, part of the signal leaving port 2 will reflect at the load and come back into the system as an input. From this measurement configuration, we can obtain V11, the amount that is reflected from the input at port 1, and V21, the amount that is transmitted to port 2 from the input at port 1. This is the second measurement we need to characterize a two-port system. Note that here we're only driving the second port. Also note that we must match terminate the first port. Again, if the first port is not match terminated for this measurement, part of the signal leaving port 1 will reflect at the load and come back into the system as an input. From this measurement configuration, we can obtain V22, the amount that is reflected from input at port 2, and V12, the amount that is transmitted from input at port 2 to port 1. The S parameters of the network describe the flow of voltage along these four possible paths. The S parameters of an in-port network will typically be reported as an N by N matrix, where there are N squared possible signal paths. For a two-port network, the S parameters are a 2x2 matrix with four elements. S11 is a measure of the reflection at port 1. S12 is a measure of transmission to port 1 from port 2. S21 is a measure of transmission to port 2 from port 1. And S22 is a measure of reflection at port 2. This is the general equation for the S parameter element Sij. It is equal to the square root of the characteristic impedance at port J times the voltage exiting port I, divided by the square root of the characteristic impedance at port I, times the voltage entering port J, assuming that the input at all other ports is zero. This can also be written purely symbolically, like this. Note that if all ports have the same characteristic impedance, this expression simplifies to this. Moving forward, we will make the assumption that systems use standardized characteristic impedance that is equal at all ports. In real life, this is usually the case, but not always. If you ever need to deal with mismatched port impedances, Just remember that all voltages at a port must be scaled by the square root of the characteristic impedance at that port. For the case of a two-port system, the elements are defined according to these equations, and the total voltage coming out each port may be written as this weighted combination of the input voltages. This may also be expressed in matrix form, as shown here. Now, before we leave S parameters, let's look at two possible circuit characteristics, losslessness and reciprocity, in terms of the S parameters. If a network is lossless, the total power leaving the system must equal the total power entering the system. Power is related to the square of the voltage. So the sum of the squares of the output voltage magnitudes has to equal the square of the input voltage magnitude. This translates to this relationship for a two-port network. This can also be written like this for an in-port network. In other words, if a network is lossless, the sum of the squared magnitudes of all the elements in a column of the S matrix is equal to 1. If a network is reciprocal, each element in the S matrix must equal its diagonal. So for example, S21 must equal S12. S23 must equal S32. Sij must equal Sji. This can be written like this. The S matrix of a reciprocal system is equal to its transpose.